Oh, why, Gladys, this is a surprise.
I'll bet it is. I'm sorry to break into your little party, Miss Connie Allenberry, but this man happens to be my husband.
This is the lady I told you about, Miss Gladys Benton.
Mrs. William Chandler's the name.
Oh, yes, how do you do?
I said Mrs. William Chandler.
I've been looking forward to meeting you. Bill's told me so much about you.
He told you about me?
Oh, yes. Won't you sit down?
Oh, no, you don't. You're not getting out of here.
Oh, I'm not leaving. I just don't want Warren to miss anything. Hello. Hello. Could you hear all right, or shall we start over?
Oh, hello, Mr. Haggerty. Do come in. It's so nice to see you. Let's all sit down.
Yes, let's.
Well, what are you doing here?
Naturally, she didn't expect you.
I didn't know he was out there. This has nothing to do with you or your newspaper, so you keep out of it. As Mrs. William Chandler, I demand that I...
Oh! There must be some mistake. You see, this is Mrs. Chandler.
What?
What?
Yes, it has been for a whole hour.
Yes, we were just married.
Have you gone crazy?
If you think you can excuse this by pulling a marriage tag, you've just got...
We are married, really.
Oh, yes. I always carry our marriage certificate right with me.
Mrs. Elmer, they're married, all right.
Oh, but that's awesome.
You mean it's bigamy? What a story. Connie Allenberry marries bigamist.
Oh, if you print that in your paper, you'll have another libel suit on your hands. I'm not a bigamist.
You married me, didn't you?
Well, that one doesn't count.
What are you talking about?
About a certain Mr. Joseph Simpson, your lawfully wedded husband?
What are you trying to hand me? I've been divorced from Simpson for...
Oh, well, you see, you got your divorce in Yucatan by mail. Well, 3 years ago, all Yucatan divorces were declared illegal. I found that out yesterday in the Hall of Records. Also consulted my attorney.
Then you and Gladys were never really married?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Oh, but it's all right. I made an honest man of him. Oh, dear, don't forget the letter.
Yes. This is from Mrs. Chandler for you, Warren. You know, she was so touched by your pity for your 500 starving employees.
You dropped the suit.
Oh,
but
Connie.
Miss Allen, Mrs. Chandler, how can I ever... I just can't thank you. Well, Connie Allenberry marries author. What a story, what a scoop.
Oh, Mr. Haggerty, you've forgotten something.
Oh, yes, my hat, excuse me.
Your hat and Mrs. Simpson?
Mrs. Simpson? Oh, Gladdy, of course.
That Mrs. Simpson gets me, Gladdy. Now I've got to run along to the office, hon. You phone me there in the morning, huh? You sweet little...
Just a minute. You want a real scoop? Well, I'll give you one. I found out my Yucatan divorce was no good, so I got a second divorce from Joe Simpson in Reno.
What?
What?
Well, then we're not...
I don't believe it.
Then try the Reno Hall of Records.
But if
that's you're... quite right. Now, where do we all stand?
Let's all sit down and talk things over quietly.
You and I'll have plenty of time to talk this over on our world cruise. I'm quite certain Miss Allenberry won't mind turning her ticket over to me now.
Ticket? World cruise? What are you talking about?
Honey, you're getting all excited. Now, come along with
what
me.
What about this?
It's nothing, Bill. It's nothing at all.
Yes, what about this?
Honey, I can explain that thing. I had to use it as a little gag.
Oh, so it's just one of your little gags to get me here. Well, I'm here all right. And before I'm through, you'll all be sorry you ever saw me. You were all terribly smart, weren't you? You were all building up to a nice, happy ending. Haggerty wins his case, Chandler wins his girl. Well, where do I stand? I'll tell you where. Right behind the eight ball. You thought it was a lot of fun, didn't you, making me fall for you? Well, I did fall. But I'm picking myself up, William Chandler. You can't fool me anymore with your hoof, 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 or your insomnia, or your publisher. You're a pretty poor sample of a husband. But nobody else is gonna get you, not if it kills both of us.
Oh,
and you're 10 times worse than he is. At least he had some excuse for kicking me around. He was in love with another woman. But you double-crossed me for the sake of a newspaper. Well, marry the paper and be the proud father of a lot of headlines. That's all you're good for anyway. I suppose this is all very distasteful to you, Miss Allenberry. You're not accustomed to hearing the truth. You've had enough money to protect you from it all your life. You've spent your entire life buying anything you want. Well, my husband isn't for sale. You can't buy him at any price.
Gladys,
will you let me
Gladys,
get out of
here?
You
can't walk out of me like this.
Gladys.
Gladys. Gladys.
Wait a minute.